and today I'm going to do the question answer segment. In my last makeup video, that is the coral monochromatic look, I have told that I'm going to do a question answer video, and I have told you guys to comment down below or inbox me your questions you want me to answer, and today I'm going to answer those questions. And another big thing, my channel, it is our channel, Dreamy Strokes, have completed 1 month successfully, and it was amazing. I was thinking that I just completed 1 month, and all because of you all support, and like I can't describe how much you have supported me and loved me throughout this 1 month. You guys told me to make this video, that video, make dance video, and I just followed it, and it helped me a lot. It always worked in a team, and I'm so glad. All of my friends, family members, my mind is just blown away with your love and support. I'm so glad and thankful. Please keep on supporting me, and I will come out with more interesting content. Thank you. So today I'm going to answer some of the questions in this video, so stay tuned. Okay, so question number one is how I got interest in makeup and how I managed to do everything like makeup, dance and study at a time. So makeup, like interest in makeup, it was since when I was at the age of 5. So my mom got me admitted into a dance school and I practiced dancing there. So when the function used to occur, then the makeup artist came and did a full face of glam, and I loved it. But my mom is so naturally beautiful, she never applied makeup. She used to do her eyebrow, lipstick and a compact powder, nothing else. She used to apply those three things only. So I was like, no, I need to purchase. So I was like, when I was in class 5-6, so Amazon came at that time, or maybe in class 6-7. So I was so much interested. I first bought a CC cream, a baby lips, iconic kajal. Then dheere dheere I used to, you know, take my pocket money and raise the fund to buy the makeup. Then I bought one highlighter, one contour palette, this lipstick, that lipstick. In that way I built my own makeup kit, and then I started doing that by seeing YouTube videos when I was in the age of class 10. So yeah, in that way it grew. Then I practiced for a few years. Obviously now I'm in second semester, so in that way it grew. And how I manage study, dance and makeup, it's like ho jata hai. But my makeup, if I talk about makeup, my mom is like, abar makeup noshto korche. My dad is like, abar eshab niye bosheche. Because I'm like, makeup, when I'm doing makeup, I'm in the world of that. So I don't bother about the external world. That's my fault. And dance, my mom and dad is very supportive about it. They tell me to do this dance. My friends tell me, suggest me to do that dance. So my nano wale video, my previous makeup video, thunder art video, everything was suggested by my friends to do this, do that. So it worked in a team, and I'm so grateful. And study, yeah, I forgot what is studying this lockdown. Like everything is off. But previous, like before the lockdown, I used to do when the exam used to arrive. I'm so shameful about it. Sorry. Okay, so the next question is, CC cream or BB cream, which one is better? I personally love CC cream because of this effect. I use the Lakme CC cream, which is in the aloe version, and it's in the shade honey. I love the glow. I wear it every day in my college, and I miss going to college, but I wear this that every day in my college, and that's super nice CC cream. And if I talk about BB cream, certain BB creams give a little more coverage than the CC cream, but CC cream makes your skin looks really nice, like really healthy. It gives a really healthy glow and makes your skin a little bit look better. But BB creams are not like, it will not give you a glow as such, because I have used the Pond's BB cream, but I prefer CC creams. I really love CC creams. So the question is, why we need a primer beneath our makeup? So we need a primer beneath our makeup because you need to choose a primer according to your skin type first, because the skin concerns are different in different persons. So since I have pores, I use a silicone based primer, because a silicone based primer instantly covers those pores and gives my skin a very nice blurred and smooth effect for my foundation to glide on smoothly. So for your foundation or base to glide on smoothly, and if just to show that there is no texture on your skin, you need a primer. But if you don't have any texture on your skin and you need a glow from within, you can use an illuminating primer. It's really nice. So primer is really important. I skip primer a lot of times before, but now I can't do a small bit of makeup also without a primer. I need a primer in my life. A primer is really, really important for your makeup or your base to glide on smoothly and to make your skin look really nice and healthy. One of my friends commented that give a good eyeshadow palette recommendation which have really nice colors and affordable too. So I will suggest this palette. This is the Wet n Wild palette. This is the Wet n Wild palette. It's in the variant Rose in the Air. It's really pretty, affordable, $4.99 I guess, but you can obviously get an offer with $3.99 only. And the color scheme, this is the color scheme, and all the shades are freaking pigmented. I'm not kidding, it's freaking pigmented. Even the light shade, like this white, then this mauve shade, it's so pigmented. I love this palette. And you can also go for the Nika K range. They have amazing palettes within 500, super pigmented. But in one palette, you're not going to get all the shades, but like all the variable shades. But this is amazing. You can create 10 to 15 eye looks with this palette. So yeah. Then the question is, again an eyeshadow related question. How to, like, what is the best eyeshadow for smoky eye? So for smoky eye, I really like the Maybelline one, but the pigments are not really that good. You know, I don't like the pigment of the Maybelline palettes. Like, it's so chalky, not blendable, gives a lot of fallout. So I don't prefer that palette. So if you want an affordable one, go for this Wet n Wild palettes, but in a different, they have a Nude Awakening one, so you can buy that one. Or if you want a little, you know, good pigmented eyeshadow palette, decent quality, go for Makeup Revolution one. They have amazing palettes, and you can get any kind of palette you need, like for a smoky eye, for warmer tones, for neutral tones. They have different palette. For colorful palettes, they have again another palette, so you can choose Makeup Revolution palettes also. Another question was, what to do for double chin. Now, double chin is basically like when you get a thing over here, you know, that's cute, I like it. But if you want to hide it, you have to do exercise, but I'm not sure that's gonna be very much effective. Like the exercise, I know, I'm not an expertise or something, but I just know it. Like to do, like to make a fish face and then raise the chin up and keep the face like that for 30 seconds and releases, and to continue it for 10 times in a day. So like this. I don't really know that it is gonna work or not, because I never had a double chin, but I saw in many YouTube videos YouTubers and beauty bloggers doing this exercise, so you can try it. And let's give you a trick, contouring. So you can take your contour powder or a cream contour, and you can make a sharp line right here, like this. Okay, very sharp, so it gives a really nice shadowy effect. Choose a contour palette which is according to your skin tone and just do it, and give a little bit of contour on your double chin, where you have the double chin, right here. Okay, so it will give a shadow, like a good jawline effect when you give a shadow right here. And use a lighter shade like this to got the contour, so to make it look a little sharper, so you can do that trick. Again, this is effective one. This will not give you a permanent solution. You have to do it whenever you do makeup, but if you want a permanent solution, you can try that exercise which I show. Okay, so again, one of my friend told me to show my hair care and skincare regime. I will make a video on that for sure, like skincare and hair care. And another friend of mine told me to say some remedy about tan removal. Tan removal, there are many remedies, and it actually works. There are some ingredients which works like a magic. The juice of potato, juice of tomato, and the juice of cucumber. So that works like insane. Apply it and keep it for around 15 to 20 minutes, then wash it off. Apply it for 3 to 4 days by keeping alternate days, and it's gonna work. I even make a paste, like I take some curd, then add honey to it, some gram flour, that is besan, to it, and just mix it, and add a little bit of turmeric, and then apply it on my face, keep it for around 25 minutes, then wash it away. It also helps in removing the tan. I will keep that video on YouTube very soon. I have already recorded it. Somebody asked me to name a brand which is a value for money. Now, it's a little bit difficult to answer, because what amount of money you want to spend, that really depends. But according to me, a value for money brand is Maybelline, for sure, except the eyeshadow palettes. I keep a little bit negative point of view towards Maybelline eyeshadow palette, but except the eyeshadow palette, I have almost used every range, like, and I loved it. So I really like Maybelline. And on the other hand, another value for money brand is Wet n Wild. Highlighter, contour palette, lipstick, eyeshadow, eye kohl, what not. I guess except the eyebrow pencil, I like everything of Wet n Wild. Very affordable. And if you want a high-end brand like that, I can suggest you Smashbox. I love Smashbox. NYX, somebody call it NYX, but I call it NYX. It's again a value for money brand. But favorite is Maybelline. Okay, so the next question is how to remove and hide dark circles. So for removing dark circle, you need to do some home remedies with ingredients which have the ability to remove the dead cells. And I won't recommend lemon under your eyes, that's harmful. You can use tomato juice, again the ones I told for tan removal. You can use the potato juice and cucumber juice. Apply something cooling, like a cool ice and a derma roller, it really helps. And you can also use eye creams. There are amazing eye creams, like the Biotique one, the Mamaearth one. The Mamaearth one is really nice. I have heard about it, but I have never used because I never faced the problem of dark circle. So for hiding dark circle, you need to get your hands on an amazing concealer, like the LA Girl Pro Conceal. It's again one of the best concealer in the concealer market. And then there is the Maybelline Age Rewind one, that's specially made for dark circles. You can use that, and it's amazing. The Maybelline Age Rewind one is really nice, and it's full coverage, but the Fit Me one is not a full coverage concealer. So I won't recommend Fit Me for dark circles. So yeah, you can do those. Okay guys, so done with the Q&A segment. That were the questions that were sent to me, and I answered those. It's gonna be a little long video, but I loved answering each and every questions, though I didn't had a proper, you know, 100% guarantee wala remedy, because I didn't face dark circles and double chin. So I can't just really say that, but I really loved answering a lot of questions. It was amazing, and I'm going to do more segments if you like this video. So if you like this video and if you find this video helpful, please give this video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and support me a little more, and share this video with your friends and family members. Thank you.